Hallelujah, good evening to everyone.
Hallelujah, 各位晚安。
May the peace and the joy of our Lord Jesus be with everyone here.
愿神的平安与大家同在。
Once again, welcome to all of our friends, family, and neighbors.
我们再一次欢迎各位亲朋好友来到这里。
Now, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I'd like to continue to share the message of God's salvation.
那我现在奉主耶稣的名来继续来分享他的道理。
The theme that we are talking about during these evangelical services is the names of God for the needs of our hearts.
我们这一次灵恩布道会的主题是神的名，神为我们的名。
Yesterday, we started with the first topic, the first name, which is that one of God's names is jealous.
那我们昨天提到说神的一个名，其中的一个名是嫉妒、忌邪的名。
In other words, this is one of his essential characteristics.
那这就是神的一个个性。
And this jealousy arises due to the fact that he is the one true God.
那神会嫉妒是因为他是独一的真神。
And he also created us.
那他也创造了我们。
But we humans often turn away from him and pursue other so-called gods.
但是我们人常常离开神，追求其他的神。
Whether they are physical idols or other things.
那有可能是食物造成的偶像，或者一些其他的事情。
So God is jealous for us to return to him and acknowledge him for who he truly is.
所以神会嫉妒，希望我们回到他身边来认识他是谁。
Now, so that was a beginning introduction to the God that is revealed to us in the Bible.
那这就是我们昨天介绍的神。
And so tonight we want to continue with another name and title of God.
那今天晚上我想要继续讲神的另外一个名。
Which is Emmanuel.
那就是以马内利。
Let's turn to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 1.
我们翻到马太福音第一章。
Matthew chapter 1.
马太福音第一章。
From verse 21.
从二十一节开始。
Matthew chapter 1, verse 21.
马太福音第一章二十一节。
And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Verse 22.
二十二节。
So all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, verse 23.
二十三节。
Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. Please read.
二十一节，马太福音一章二十一节，他将要生一个儿子，你要给他起名叫耶稣，因他要将自己的百姓从罪恶里救出来。二十二节，这一切的事成就，就是要应验主借先知所说的话。二十三节，说。必有童女怀孕生子，人要称他的名为以马内利。以马内利翻出来就是神与我们同在。
In these short three verses, we can see that there are two names that are mentioned.
在这短短三节中有两个名字被提到。
The first name is in verse 21, which is Jesus.
第一个名字是二十一节所提到的耶稣。
This name, I think, we are all very familiar with.
那我们对这个名字都非常的熟悉。
This is also something I'll talk about in a few more moments, right?
那我待会会回到这个名字来。
But the second name that's mentioned is found in verse 23.
那但是第二个名字提到的是在二十三节。
Which is that the birth of Lord Jesus Christ fulfilled a prophecy where a son will be born and his name shall be called Emmanuel.
那二十三节讲到的就是说神耶稣的出生应许的一个先知的预言，那他的名字叫做以马内利。
And very clearly here, the meaning of Emmanuel is given to us.
那以马内利的名字就是给我们。
Emmanuel is Hebrew, but here is translated God with us.
那这本来是希伯来文，在这里翻出来的意思就是神与我们同在。
So tonight I'd like to especially focus on the name Emmanuel.
所以我今天晚上想要集中在以马内利这个名字上。
And I'd like to share three main points to introduce this God that we worship.
那我想要分享三点来介绍我们这个敬我们敬拜的神。
The first point is that this name reveals how God loves us so deeply.
那这个名字就是显示说神多么的爱我们。
Secondly, this name points to how God became flesh. He became Jesus Christ.
那第二点就是神怎么样道成肉身成为耶稣。
And then thirdly, Emmanuel, this name points to how Jesus eventually died on the cross for us.
那第三点就是耶稣到最后被钉十字架为我们而死。
So we will use these three points to talk about this name.
那所以我们用这三点来讲这个名字。
So first, let's talk about how this name reveals God's great love.
那所以我们第一点提到说要怎么透过这个名字将神的爱所显现出来。
Yesterday, we were talking about how God is a jealous God.
我们昨天说神是一个嫉妒的神。
And we talked about how God's jealousy is aroused if His creation, humankind, pursues other so-called gods.
那我们昨天有提到说，当我们人追求其他的神、其他的事情的时候，神的愤怒就会燃起。
This type of unfaithfulness, infidelity, is called in the Bible. It's called sin.
那这个在圣经中就解释这个行为为一个罪。
This is the very definition of what sin is.Sin is something that offends God.
那罪的定义就是神所不喜悦的事情。
But this type of sin, like the sin of idolatry, is not the only type of sin.
那当然，圣经所讲到的罪不是只是限制在奸淫上面。
There are many other different types of actions or even thoughts that are also called sins because they offend God.
我们知道说有很多其他的行为或甚至想法都成为罪，因为他们是神所不喜悦的。
Much of these moral principles and laws are recorded in the Bible for us to know.
那这些原则都记载在圣经里给我们知道。
Things like stealing from another, this is a sin.
那就像从我们偷窃其他人的东西是一个罪。
Of course, you not only hurt other human beings, but this is something that offends the one true God.
你不但伤害了其他人，这也是神所不喜悦的。
Things also like lying.
像是说谎。
Or even hating another person.
或者是讨厌另外一个人。
Or coveting the possessions of someone else.
或者是贪好其他人的东西。
These actions and also these types of thoughts, from the Bible, we can see that they are also sins.
这些行为或想法，从圣经来上，我们都知道这是罪。
Now Scripture tells us that the punishment for sin actually is death.
那经文告诉我们说，罪的代价是死。
Not only will we physically die, but we also face spiritual death.
不但我们肉体会死，而且我们的灵性也会死。
Which means that our soul will be eternally separated from God and thrown into the lake of fire.
那属灵的死就是我们的灵魂会与神永远的隔绝，然后我们会丢到地狱的火湖中。
And so when we think about our actions, our thoughts, if we're really honest with ourselves, we all know that we fall short of God's moral standards.
所以当我们思考我们自己的行为跟言语的时候，还有思想的时候，我们其实都知道我们没有达到神的标准。
We perhaps could be idolatrous sometimes, right?
那有时候我们的想法可能是不好的。
Right? Sometimes we can be rebellious against God.
我们知道有时候我们人都会叛逆。
Sometimes the thoughts that we have are impure in God's eyes.
那有时候我们的想法在神的眼中也不是单纯的。
And so from God's point of view, this is deserving of eternal punishment.
那所以从神的角度来看，这样的行为跟想法就是可以被叛
逆。But even though this is the spiritual truth, right? This is the truth.
是可以被惩罚的，虽然这是属灵上的真理。
Right? That we should be, we should face spiritual death.
虽然我们应该要面对属灵的死。
But God did not forsake us to meet this type of spiritual fate.
但是神并没有抛弃我们，让我们面对这个这些惩罚。
One would think that God. He could have very easily just forsaken us.
我们可以想象说神可以轻易的放弃我们。
We can just think about normal human relationships.
我们可以想看我们跟人之人之间的关系。
If there's someone that you meet, whether in the workplace or out in society, And they always offend you. They're always saying things that offend you or doing things to offend you.
我们可以想象说我们在工作上或在社会中遇到一些人，那这些人不断重复的跟我们得罪我们。
Of course, we probably don't want to have anything to do with that person.
那长久之后，我们就可能不想跟这些人有关系。
Right? Even just seeing the person, we just want to go the other way.
你可能光是看到这个人的时候，你就会想要往另外一边走。
And so when you think about that type of situation, that actually is what should have happened when God sees our rebellion and our offenses towards Him.
所以将心比心的时候，其实神看到我们的时候，他应该也是同样的反应。
But this is where God is so loving.
但是就是神爱的地方，爱我们的地方。
This is what the name Emmanuel conveys.
那这就是这个名字以马内利所要告诉我们的。
God with us.
神跟我们同在。
You would think, because of all of our offenses, God wants to be away from us.
你可能会觉得说，是因为我们所有的罪，所以神会想要远离我们。
Right? It's not God away from us. It's not God far from us.
那实际上不是神要以我们远离而去。
But it's Emmanuel, God with us.
而是以马内利，神与我们同在。
For some reason, He still wants to associate with us and be with us who are often rebellious towards Him.
就算我们这样的叛逆，神还是愿意与我们同在。
So God loves us so deeply, beyond what we can even imagine.
神爱我们的深度是我们没有所了解、
The Bible tells us that God is love.
圣经告诉我们说神就是爱。
And all of us, within our hearts, we always are seeking love.
那我们的心里也都是在寻求爱。
And the one that will always be there to love us is God Himself, because He is Emmanuel. He is God with us.
那一个会永远爱着我们的人就是神，因为他与我们同在。
Recently, I was reading a testimony from a 13-year-old sister.
那最近我在读一个13岁姐妹所写的见证。
She was sharing how from age 6 to just very recently, she had a particular disorder.
那这个姐妹分享说，从6岁到最近，她有一个疾病
which is that she would be prone to pick her skin.
她有一个症状，那就是她会要去剥她的皮
right? Or bite the skin.
或者她会把她的皮咬掉
Whether it is consciously or unconsciously.
有意识上的或者无意识中间都会
So it started small, but as the years passed, it got worse and worse.
那一开始可能一点点而已，那后来每一年一年过去，越来越糟糕
And she would especially pick at the skin of her fingers.
那特别是会把她手上的皮肤咬掉。
So when she was age 12, she actually started to realize that this is a very scary disorder.
那她在12岁的时候，她忽然意识到说这是非常危险的事情。
And she started to look into what was this called.
那所以她就开始寻找说这个症状叫做什么。
And she eventually found the medical term for this type of this mental illness actually.
那他后来终于找到说这个精神病的症状的名称。
And it's actually usually caused by stress.
那这个症状通常是后来发现是因为压力引起的。
She said at that point in time, all the skin of her right index finger and half the skin of her middle finger was basically like ripped off, very raw.
那他说在那个时候，他基本上他的食指跟一半的中指的皮肤几乎全部都被咬掉了。
And her mother started to notice this too. So, she was just warning that if you keep doing that, you eventually get an infection.
那她妈妈后来也终于注意到了，然后并告诉她女儿说，如果你继续这样做，你可能会感染。
So she started to try to find different ways to stop this type of behavior.
那她后来就开始寻找各种方式来停止这个行为。
Like intentionally put bandages on it.
她可能会故意把它包扎起来。
But none of these methods that she found would work.
但是这些方式都没有办法停止她的行为。
And so eventually she even started to cut herself.
那之后她更是开始的会拿刀割自己。
So she knew that she was in a very poor mental state at this time.
所以她便意识到说她的精神状况非常的不
好。She felt that she was always drowning in a sea of emotions.
她意识到说她永远是在感情的海中游荡。
She was had a lot of stress and anxiety.
她很多压力，很多不安。
She also did not have many friends.
那她同时间也没有很多朋友。
And even if she did, she probably would not really share this with them. Right?
那就算他有朋友，他也不会愿意跟他朋友分享这些事情。
And so when she was thinking about this, about friendship, one day she suddenly realized that God is my friend.
那当他在思考他的友情跟朋友的友谊的时候，他忽然有一天意识到说，神就是我的朋友。
I can tell him about my problem, about what I'm worried about.
我可以告诉神我在担心的什么事情。
When she had that realization, she just broke down to tears.
当他意识到这一点的时候，他便开始哭泣。
She felt like she had this heavy weight removed from her shoulders.
然后他觉得说他的重担从他肩膀上提走了。
There's someone that can solve this, and that someone was with her all this time. She just never really realized it.
他直到终于意识到说有人可以帮他解决这个问题，而这个人一直都跟他同在。
So later, after that, later that week, after this realization, she saw somebody, I think, on the street that perhaps had a similar condition.
那差不多在一个礼拜之后，他在街上看到街上有一个人。好像也跟他有同样的症状。
And she saw that this lady was older and it was a very, very poor condition.
那他这个啊，这个女性是非年比较年长的，然后她的状况非常的糟糕。
So she was horrified that maybe one day she would wind up like that as well.
那所以这个姐妹也很担心，说有一天她可能就会变跟这个女性一样。
So the very next Sabbath day, she went to the church.
所以下一个安息日，她就去了教会。
And she prayed very hard. And just poured out her heart, spilled everything to God.
所以她就非常努力的祷告，并在祷告中将所有一切事情告诉神。
And in that prayer, she felt God listening to her.
在那个祷告中，她也觉得神听听。
When she got up from that prayer, she felt so much better.
那她从那个祷告起来之后，她觉得非常的好。
As the following week passed, she just felt like the stress that she kept on holding inside just started to get lighter and lighter.
那从那个开始之后，歇下来一个礼拜，他就觉得他体内啊，同身体上的压力就越来越减轻。
And slowly, unconsciously, she stopped picking at her skin.
那慢慢的，他就病啊，就开始没有咬他的皮。
And within a few months, she completely stopped, and the skin started to heal itself.
那几个月之后，他就完全停止了，他的皮肤也开始恢复。
So this disorder that had affected her half her life was healed by God in just those short months, right?
那所以这个症状啊，打扰他一半的生命，竟把被神所医治好。
It started with the realization that God is right there with her.
那这个神医治好他的第一步就是他意识到了神跟他同在。
Right, that she can go to him for any situation.
也是他意识到说他可以去找神，告诉在任何状况去找神。
Just like the name that we have been talking about, Emmanuel, God is with us.
就像我们这边所提到的，以马内利，神跟我们同在。
So even though we have been rebellious, but God, He did not disown us.
虽然我们可能会叛逆，但是神并没有抛弃我们。
He loves us and wants to be with us.
神爱我们，也想要跟我们同在。
We can always turn to Him, no matter what our troubles are.
不管我们遇到什么状况，我们总是可以找神。
Now, Emmanuel, God with us.Is not only to be taken figuratively.
那神与我们同在不是只是表面至上的意思。
Right, but literally it became true as well.
那在我们知道说这个在字面不但是字面上，而实际上也是如此。
Because the Almighty God eventually became incarnated. He took on human form. He was fully flesh and blood. Right.
因为我们知道说这伟大的神后来也道成肉身。
Right? So Emmanuel points to the incarnation of God, that God literally was with us, humankind, in the present and in the physical form. Right?
所以以马内利同时也是指说神道成肉身来到世界上跟我们实际肉体上同在。
Right.And this is what we were just reading before in the book of Matthew, chapter 1.
这就是我们在马太福音第一章所读到的。
Right, the words that we read in verse 21 basically were the words of an angel to Joseph, the father the husband of Mary.
那这个话是天使向一个玛利的先生说。所说的。
Right, at that time, Mary was already betrothed to Joseph, so basically like promised to him, but they had not yet consummated the marriage.
那在那个时候，玛丽已经跟约瑟有婚约了，但是他们实际上还没有结婚，
right.
正式结婚。
Before Mary was truly married to him, he noticed that she was already pregnant.
那所以这个先生意识到说，虽然他们还没有结婚，但是玛丽亚已经怀孕了。
Right. And so Joseph in his heart was considering that he would put her away secretly, divorce her secretly.
那所以约瑟就在心里想说，他要离婚，把这个。
But while he was thinking about these things, that was when the angel appeared to him and told those words that we just read.
但是他还在想这件事情的时候，天使便与向他显现，然后告诉他刚才我们所读的。
That do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife.
他说不要害怕娶玛利亚为你的妻子。
Because the child that she is with is conceived of the Holy Spirit.
因为她所怀孕的是从圣灵而来的。
And that she will eventually bear a son.
她将会生一个儿子。
And they are to call his name Jesus.
那她儿子的名叫耶稣。
Right. And this will fulfill the prophecy in the book of Isaiah talking about how Emmanuel will be born.
那这就是那这就是应许以赛亚书里面所提到的以马内利会出生。
Emmanuel literally became true about 2,000 years ago.
所以我们知道以马内利成为事实在2000年多年之前。
That the true and living God took on flesh and blood and was born into this world.
我们知道真神道成肉身，然后在这个世界上出生。
Let's also turn to the Gospel of John.
我们接下来看约翰福音。
It's Gospel of John, chapter 1.
约翰福音第一章。
The Gospel of John, chapter 1.
约翰福音第一章。
Verse 1.
第一节。
John chapter 1, verse 1.
约翰福音第一章第一节。
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Please read.
第一节，马太福音第一章第一节。太初有道，道与神同在，道就是神。
This is the very first words of this gospel written by John, the Apostle John.
那这就是约翰福音第一章的开启。
Talking about how God's plan to be incarnate was already prepared all the way in the beginning.
这就提到说，神要道成肉身，在一开始就是预备好的。
Right. So the Word in the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God.
所以这边提到说，太初有道，道与神同在，道就是神。
And let's now jump to verse 14.
我们跳到十四节。
John chapter 1 verse 14.
约翰福音第一章十四节。
And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
十四节，道成的肉身住在我们中间，充充满满的有恩典有真理。我们也见过他的荣光，正是父独生子的荣光。
So here we can see the Word, which was God, became flesh and dwelt among human beings.
所以我们可以看到这边写到说，这个道成了肉身，与并我们人同在。
So God, he's spirit, he's invisible.
我们知道说神是灵，那灵是看不见的。
This is also the way that people related to God for millennia.
那我们也知道，这是我们在一般人对神的认知。
Even the Jews, they had never seen God.
因为就连犹太人他们都没有看过神。
But God became flesh, and so human beings could behold this manifestation of God.
那但是说神道成的肉身，所以人可以看得到神。
And so here it says how humankind beheld God's glory.
所以这边讲到说神人怎么迎接神的荣耀。
That the God became in the flesh as Jesus Christ and was full of grace and truth.
这边讲到说他道成肉身，充满了荣光。
And so this is the God that Christians worship.
那这就是我们基督徒所敬拜的神。
This is the Jesus that all Christians worship.
这就是我们基督徒所敬拜的耶稣。
That is we believe and worship a God.Who loves his fallen creation so much that he was willing to become like his creation, to be physically dwelling with them.
我们敬拜的神是一个爱他所创造物的神，爱到说就算他的 创造的人失败了，他也愿意给道成肉身与他们同在。
Now, what was the purpose of God taking on flesh and blood?
那神道成肉身的意义意义是什么呢？
Why is it that he had to be with us physically?
为什么神需要实际上肉体与我们同在呢？
No, God had to be with us because actually he would eventually die for us, his creation.
神要与我们道成肉身与我们同在的原因，就是因为到时候他会为我们而死。
So Emmanuel also points to how God who was physically with us would eventually die on the cross for us.
那以马内利就是也是讲到说神与我们同在，但是他也会到时候会为我们而死。
Right, so this is one of the major reasons why God did take on flesh.
那就是神为什么要道成肉身的一个主要原因。
I mean, there's other reasons as well.
当然有其他的原因。
For example, in verse 18.
其他原因像是我们看十八节。
Right, no one has seen God at any time. The only Son, the only begotten Son who is in the bosom of the Father, he has declared him.
十八节，从来没有人看见神。只有在父怀里独生子将他表明出来。
So one of the other reasons why God did take on flesh is to make himself known, to reveal, right, his nature to his creation.
所以神道成肉身的另外一个原因就是为了要让世人认识他。
To know God better through his words and through his deeds.
让人透过他的行为跟他的话语认识他。
But one of the primary reasons why he did take on flesh is because eventually he was preparing to die for us.
但是其中一个最主要原因，他会道成肉身来到世界上的原因，就是他会为我们而死。
Let's turn to Romans chapter 6.
我们看罗马书第六章。
Romans chapter 6.
罗马书第六章。
Verse 23.
二十三节。
Romans chapter 6, verse 23.
罗马书第六章二十三节。
Says, for the wages of sin is death. Let's just stop right there. Right?
那我们罗马书第六章二十三节，因为罪的工价乃是死。
This is something that I mentioned earlier, but here is the scriptural text that telling us that the wages of sin is death. Right?
那我之前有提到，那这就是圣经上所记载说罪的工价乃是死。
Right? So as we mentioned before, our rebellion against God.There is a just consequence to that, which is death.
那我们之前有提到说，我们抵抗神的代价就是罪，就是死。
But if we keep reading verse 23,
但是我们继续读二十三节的话
，It says, "But the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord."
二十三节继续说到，唯有神的恩赐在我们的主基督耶稣里乃是永生。
Which is telling us that even though we as sinners deserve death.We can have eternal life, right? The complete opposite of death, if we believe in Jesus Christ.
这也就是告诉我们说，虽然我们犯罪的代价是死，但是在基督耶稣里面，我们可以得到永生。
And this eternal life, is given unto us because Jesus Christ dies for us, taking the consequence of sin with him.
那我们之所以可以得到永生，就是因为主耶稣基督为我们在十字架而死，帮我们的罪所带走了。
He can only have accomplished that by coming into the flesh and dying for us to take on the consequence of sin.
那为了要达到此目的，达到这样子的目的，他就必须要道成肉身。
Yeah, so basically, his death paid the price, paid the consequence in full.Of our sins.
所以主耶稣的死就将我们罪的代价所偿还了。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 20, verse 28.
我们看马太福音二十章二十八节。
Matthew chapter 20, verse 28.
马太福音二十章二十八节。
We can read from verse 27.
我们从二十七节开始读。
Matthew chapter 20, verse 27.
马太福音二十章二十七节。
And whoever desires to be first among you, let him be your slave. Verse 28.
28节。
Just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many.
27节。 谁愿为首，就必做你们的仆人。二十八节，正如人子来，不是要受人的服侍，乃是要服侍人，并且要舍命做多人的赎价。
You can see these are the very words of Jesus Christ when he was physically on this earth.
我们这边可以看到说，这是主耶稣基督亲口所说的。
Of course, the main message he was trying to convey here was how his disciples need to be servants of other people.
那当然，最主要主耶稣所讲这两句话的目的是说，他要告诉他的门徒，他们要成为仆人。
Right? If you want to be great, you have to lower yourself to serve others.
如果你想要当为首，你必须要降低自己的身份服侍人。
But you can see that in passing, he also talks about what he eventually was going to accomplish.
但是在这讲他在告在他讲话的过程中，他便透露他所要达到的。
He was going to use he's using himself as an example here now.
他将要用他自己，他用他自己当做一个例子。
The Son of Man is referring to himself.
人子就是指主耶稣本身。
He came into this world.
他来到
not to be served, not to be like a king.
他来到这个世界不是为了被人服侍，不是为了当王。
But he came to serve.
他来到世界上是为了服侍人。
And the greatest service, right? The greatest gift that he gives is he gives his own life as a ransom for many.
那这边他所给我们最大的礼物，便是他用他的生命作为我们的赎价。
So here especially mentions ransom.
那这边讲到说赎价。
Right? This is referring to what we were talking about and reading in the book of Romans.
那这个赎价就是指我们刚才在罗马书所读到的。
Normally, when we think about ransom, you might think of like a kidnapping, right?
但我们通常讲到赎价的时候，可能我们会想到说有人被绑架。
Right, so like if a child is kidnapped, the kidnappers may ask like the parents to pay a ransom so the person can go free. Right?
那当然，如果像说我们如果有时候常常看到小孩被绑架的时候，绑架犯就会跟他们父母亲要赎价来赎这个小孩。
But here in the spiritual sense, this ransom is referring to the price needed in order for us human beings not to face spiritual death.
那但是在这边所讲的赎价，便是指说我们需要付出的赎价来让我们避免属灵上的死。
So Jesus is ready here to give up his life, to use that life as a price, as a price to pay for our eternal life, for our spiritual freedom.
所以这边我们可以看到说，主耶稣已经有决心，也准备好要舍命来作为我们的赎价。
So in his eventual crucifixion.
那我们知道说，最后主耶稣被钉十字架的时候
，Jesus truly laid down his life for us.
他就变成将他的命所给舍去了。
And he spilled his precious blood so that we can have a way to be reconciled to God.
那他也流了他宝贵的血，所以我们可以跟神和好。
So Emmanuel refers to how God was incarnate and then how he eventually died for us.
那所以以马内利便是也是告诉我们说，神道成肉身并为我们而死。
He had to come into flesh in order to give us this precious blood.
他必须要道成肉身才可以为我们而死。
According to the book of Hebrews, let's turn to Hebrews.
我们来看希伯来书。
Chapter 9.
第九章。
Hebrews chapter 9.
希伯来书第九章。
Let's read verse 22.
我们来看二十二节。
Hebrews chapter 9, verse 22.
希伯来书第九章二十二节。
And according to the law, almost all things are purified with blood, and without shedding of blood, there is no remission. Right? So according to God's spiritual principles, whenever there is sin, you need blood in order to atone for it.
那这边讲到说，以神的规标准来看的话，如果有罪，就需要靠血将这个罪所洗去。
So in the Old Testament, the Jews would sacrifice animals to shed their blood to atone for their sins.
所以在旧约的时候，犹太人就会牺牲动物来将他们的罪所洗去。
But then this was an imperfect system because they had to keep on doing that.
但是这是一个不完美的制度，因为他们必须要一直重复的做。
So God actually had already planned long beforehand that he would come into this world to be the ultimate and perfect sacrifice.
所以神在早早之前早就准备好说他会来到这个世界上成为最完美的献祭。
So as flesh, as someone with blood, his blood was eventually spilt and shed on the cross.
那主耶稣基督来到世界上，带着他自己的血，他的血到最后就被献祭了。
And he took upon himself all of our sins, the sins of humanity.
那他便承担了人全一切的罪恶。
So even at our worst, God is with us, right? God is still Emmanuel.
啊，虽然我们人如此的糟糕，但是神还是与我们同在。
And he's willing to take upon all of that for himself.
那神也愿意他一个人承担我们的全部。
To suffer the suffer separation from God as well.
他也忍受了与神隔离的痛苦。
And to shed that precious blood so that our sins can be atoned.
然后流了他宝贵的血，就让我们的罪来被洗去。
So this is all the wonderful great things, great actions of love that God has done for us.
那这就是神他的爱所做出来对我们一切的事情。
He wants to be with us. He has not forsaken us.
神想与我们同在，他并没有离弃我们。
He came even in the flesh to be physically with us.
他爱我们到他道成肉身跟我们同在。
And then even he was willing to give up his life to pave a way for us so our sins can be cleansed and we can have eternal life.
他甚至放弃了自己的生命，所以我们的罪可以被移去。
So this is the God that we worship, Emmanuel, right? God with us.
那这就是我们所敬拜的神以马内利。
This is the God that we need to come to know and to worship.
这是我们所需要认识敬拜的神。
There was a sister, she's now our sister, but during the time period when she was still kind of seeking the truth and seeking if Christianity is true or not, she happened to be in the church on a Sabbath day.
那有一个姐妹在她还在慕道的时候，在一个安息日，她来到了教会。
And during that particular Sabbath day, the church was announcing how there was going to be a special fasting prayer session after the afternoon service.
那在那一天，刚好教会就宣布了说，在下午聚会之后有禁食祷告。
And the purpose of that prayer was because the following week they were going to have an event like this, the spiritual convocation, and they wanted to pray for God's guidance and abidance.
那他们要禁食祷告的原因，就是因为在一个礼拜之后，他们也有灵恩布道会，所以他们要祷告请求神的同在。
So this sister, who was not baptized at that time, though, she intended to just kind of sneak away after the afternoon service.
那但是这个姐妹在那个时候，她那时候还没有受洗，她便想要偷偷的离开。
But before she could get very far, the pastor's wife saw her and was inviting her to join the prayer.
那但是她离开之前，传道娘就看到她，并邀请她一起祷告。
And so she didn't really want to stay, so she was trying to come up with some excuses.
那因为这个姐妹那时候不想要留下来，所以她就便想找借口离开。
So she came up with an excuse. Oh, I actually ate earlier, so I'm not able to fast and pray.
那这个姐妹便说，我因为刚刚有吃东西，所以我现在就不能进食祷告。
But the preacher's wife was telling her, oh, you know, you don't have to worry about that. God, what God cares about the most is our heart when we pray to him.
那传道人便告诉她说，你不用在意，因为神最在乎的是我们的心。
So she was trying to come up with another excuse, but she couldn't come up with one fast enough.
那她这个姐妹就想要试着用另外一个借口离开，但是她想的不够快。
So she reluctantly agreed to stay.
所以她便还是留下来了。
So during that prayer, she just felt like the prayer was so long.
那在祷告的中间，她就觉得祷告很长。
After just a few minutes, she just felt like her whole body was aching and she was very fatigued.
那几分钟之后，她就觉得她全身都在痛，而且很累。
So she just kept on wondering, how come the preacher is not concluding the prayer? How come he's not ringing the bell?
所以她就开始想说，为什么传道还不赶快结束呢？
Yeah, but then as she was praying, she then had a thought that crossed her mind.
但是在她祷告的时候，她忽然有一个想法从她脑中闪过。
She was wondering,What about all these other brothers and sisters here? How come they're praying so hard?
那他便想到说，哎，那其他为什么其他弟兄姐妹在这边这么努力的祷告呢？
So as she was wondering about this question, she suddenly saw a vision from God.
那当他在思考这个问题的时候，他便看到了一个异象。
She saw a cross out in the distance.
他 在一个远方看到一个十字架。
And it became the scene got clearer and closer.
那这个影像便慢慢的越来越靠近。
And she saw that there was a figure hanging on this cross.
那她在看到这个十字架上有一个人。
The whole scene itself was very dark, but the only bright portion was around that cross.
这整个景象是非常黑暗的，但是在这个十字架旁边却是光亮的。
And so when she saw this, she realized that that was Jesus Christ.
所以当她看到这个时候，她意识到说这就是神，耶稣。
Tears started to flow down her cheeks.
然后当她意识到这是耶稣的时候，她便开始流泪。
All these things that she had only read about in the Bible before, now were shown directly to her.
那这些她以前只有在圣经上所读到的事情，她现在亲眼看见。
And she just felt like it was such amazing love.
她觉得说这是一个非常不可思议的爱。
How can it be that Jesus, right, the Son of God, right, that he died for her. He died for her sins.
她觉得说耶稣为她的罪而死是非常伟大的。
She realized that this is such a wonderful grace that all of our rebellion, all of our sins can be then cleansed away.
这是一个非常美好的事情，因为透过主耶稣的血，我们的罪被洗去了。
And that once that offense is removed, then we can be reconciled with our God, or with our Heavenly Father.
那当我们的罪被遗弃的时候，我们便可以与天上的父和好。
And that prayer was the way that we could communicate directly with God.
那祷告便是我们向神沟通的方法。
So after seeing that vision, she no longer dared to wonder and question why the prayer was so long.
那她在看到那个异象之后，她便不会再疑问说为什么祷告这么长。
So visions like this occur in the church fairly often.
那我们知道说，在教会中这样的异象是常常发生的。
Sometimes God opens the eyes of visitors or our members to see that He died on the cross for them.
有时候神会让我们的信徒或者是慕道者看到说，他为了我们在十字架上而死。
Last summer in Flushing, there was a young brother who also saw Jesus Christ die on the cross at the baptismal site.
那去年在法拉盛教会有一个弟兄，年轻的弟兄看到说，在洗礼的时候看到说主耶稣死在十字架上。
A young brother, yeah. But yeah, these type of visions are quite common.
这是我们教会常常会发生的异象。
To tell us that really God loves us so much.
那为了就是要告诉我们说神非常的爱我们。
That He is Emmanuel, He wants to be with us.
他是以马内利，他想与我们同在。
He loves us deeply.
他深爱着我们。
And He's worthy of us returning that love with adoration and true worship.
那他也是值得我们所爱跟敬仰的。
Right. So may all of us respond to God's invitation and love to us.
那愿我们所有的人都可以回应神的爱。
God wants to be with us.
God, 神想要与我们同在。
Do we want to be with Him?
我们想要跟神同在吗？
Let's now sing Hymn 454.
我们唱诗
454首
454